Hello and welcome to another Bearded Geek toy review. In today's episode, we've got a special one. We're looking at the Marvel Legends Spider-Man No Way Home free figure pack. Stay tuned.
Let's do this.
Welcome back to the channel, and we have an absolute brilliant piece of action figure merchandise here for you today. The Spider-Man No Way Home free figure pack from Hasbro's Marvel Legends series. This is featuring, obviously, the spoilers. If you haven't seen the film, it came out in December 2021. I'm not going to give you any more spoiler warnings. If you haven't seen the film already, you can kind of guess that all three actors who have portrayed Spider-Man in the movies turn up in this film. So obviously you have Tom Holland, who is the current MCU Spider-Man and has been portraying him since 2016 in Marvel's Civil War. You have Tobey Maguire, who was the original cinematic Spider-Man, although some of us will argue that that was actually Nicholas Hammond, some of us of a certain generation, who portrayed Spider-Man in the Sam Raimi trilogy from 2002 to 2007. And then you have Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man, who appeared in the two Amazing Spider-Man films in 2012 and 2014. And then, unfortunately, he was I don't think he was kind of like sacked from the role, but he was kind of like cast aside when Sony did a deal with Marvel Studios to then bring Spider-Man into the MCU. Which is a big shame because he, as will become apparent in this video, he is my favourite Spider-Man. So this is the packaging. It gives you the poses that they had in the climactic battle when on top of the Statue of Liberty. Lovely packaging. Spider-Man logo there. Lovely bit of artwork on the side there of all Spider-Men swinging into battle with some electricity there from Electro. And again, some lovely artwork on the side there featuring them on the scaffolding. And then on the back, we have details of the actual figures themselves and what they come with. So these are not actual photographs. These are like CG renders that were first issued when they announced this set. Way back last year, it's taken them some time to produce this because when you actually think about it, it's like a full 18 months since this movie was released. I presume because of the confidential clauses and the fact that they wanted to keep Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield's appearance in the film secret, that this is why these figures never were in the original Spider-Man No Way Home wave that came out at the time of the movie being released. And obviously it takes a while to tool action figures, and I'm pretty sure that, you know, even though they're in a free pack here, we will get these figures re-released at some point down the line. There has been some speculation that they will be re-released separately with maskless head sculpts, but Bandai, who hold the rights to the action figure license for Japan, not Hasbro, they released their own version of Marvel figures under the SH Figure Arts line. They have done, obviously, a Tom Holland with out the mask with his likeness. They've done a Tobey Maguire without a mask, an alternative head with his likeness. The Andrew Garfield one that they've released doesn't have an alternative head. So I don't know if there is a particular issue with Andrew Garfield, whether he's refused his likeness. I'm sure it's covered in the clauses of the contract when they sign up for these movies, or whether he just didn't like his likeness. And, you know, they have the right to refuse if they think it doesn't look good enough. So we'll have to wait and see to see if these will get re-released at some point. These are the extras that they come with. So they all come with an extra two pairs of hands, and then you get free web lines for them as well. Anyway, enough about that. Enough about the box. let's get the box cracked open and have a look at these figures. I have to say, that is really snug in there. Wow, to get out. That was a bit of a struggle. So here we have the internal inner packaging. And again, it's all plastic free. And a little bit of a safety thing here. I think we've got the individual bags with their alternate hands. So we'll have to figure out which ones are which. These are not sealed, actually, unlike some other releases that we've had recently. They're just like, obviously, twisted there. And then I presume that's the web lines. In fact, oh yeah, oh, and they're actually translucent plastic, unlike the white plastic that's shown on the packaging. So that's the web lines there. And then let's try and get the, how do we get these figures out? Bloody hell, they don't make it easy, do they? There we go, I think that's Toby. That looks like Tom. And that looks like my old mate Andrew Garfield.
Yeah, I'm on it!
Peter, I need the lizard cure!
Okay!
Okay, first of all, let's go with Peter One, who is the MCU Spider-Man, portrayed by Tom Holland. Nothing on the tissue paper that you get with it, unlike Indiana Jones. And this is, the paint job on this figure is very, very nice. This figure is the only one that is a re-release. This figure was previously released in the original Spider-Man No Way Home wave, of which I do have two figures from that wave. I've got the Doctor Strange figure, which you would have seen in my previous review that I did yesterday with the Defender Strange figure. And we've also got another figure, which I'll do a comparison of in a second. So this is a far better version. It has been souped up a little bit, just purely through a paint application point of view. The original release was a brighter red and it didn't have the web lines painted on the costume. So it's good that they've done that. That does look a lot better. I do really love the face there. That for me is like, that's proper Spider-Man with those eyes. Those are the right size eyes for Spider-Man. That's how John Romita Sr. always drew him. He recently passed away, actually. He was an absolute legend of an artist. He took over the book from pencils point of view when Steve Ditko fell out with Stan Lee and then left the book suddenly. So he then sort of like stepped in. And for me, he drew the definitive look of Spider-Man. So it's sad that he's passed away. I think he was about 91. But he leaves behind like an absolute great body of work. You know, those comics are absolutely brilliant. I loved them as a kid. So, yeah, back to the figure. The gold appears to be a better paint, brighter paint, like application there. It's more of a blue on the aspects of his costume there, where I think it was a darker, almost black, I think, on the original figure. I never got that because, first of all, I didn't really see it much in stores. It was one that was fairly snapped up. And plus the fact that it didn't have the painted web lines made it look a bit cheaper, more plasticky. You do really need to have the web lines painted on, you know, a Spider-Man figure. But I have seen some criticism that this is not accurate. Because in the final battle, when he has this costume and he is joined with the other two Spider-Men, he doesn't have these gauntlets. He only has these gauntlets, obviously, in the early part of the film. Now, this is a similar inaccuracy to one of the other previous Spider-Man figures in the wave. So let's just stand that guy up there. If he will do, are you going to stand up for me? I hope you will. And I commented on this when I got the Doctor Strange figure and this figure. I did a double review, so you will be able to find that in the list of all the Marvel Legends reviews. He didn't have the red hands. Oh, he's just fallen down. He obviously was fully gold because this was the his previous outfit that he turned inside out in order to get that paint stain off it. And obviously he didn't have red sections on that part of the costume. So that was an inaccuracy. But, you know, you go with it. And effectively, is it the same kind of figure? Probably not. Is it the same type of head? I don't know. No, the eyes look different. The eyes are a different size. So it's not like they've retooled any bit of this actual figure. So they didn't use the same parts. Even the legs are different because of the sculpted areas of the costume there. So you can pop the gauntlets off, and obviously you can pop the hands off, and we'll look at the alternate hands in a minute. So you can pop the gauntlets off and then obviously have him without the gauntlets. But what some people have commented on is it does leave him with a little bit of a kind of like a very, very narrow looking wrist there. But I don't think that's too noticeable. If you've got him in a certain pose, that's going to be okay. I like, obviously, you've got the kind of like the web wall crawler hands there. You do come with, obviously, the other two pairs of hands are a pair of fists, which are nicely detailed and painted. And then you've got two web slinging hands, which are always good. Or rock out hands if you want to rock out. So you can have him with that there. So we could pop that off. Let's pop that off and have him web slinging with that. I'm currently undecided whether or not I'm going to leave him with the gauntlets on or off. But there you go. That is a really good figure. Better paint job, better than the previous release of this figure. So that is Tom Holland as Peter One.
Find Peter Parker!
Great, it's just some random guy.
Hello. I hope it's okay. I just came through this, just closed.
Okay, and now on to Peter 2, the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, as he's referred to, played by Tobey Maguire, the original actor from the first Spider-Man trilogy. And look at that. That's very good. I'm liking the look of this. I do have some issues with the Sam Raimi trilogy. The first film is virtually flawless, except to the point when you then get the introduction of the Green Goblin. And then it just goes off and becomes like a bloody, you know, two action figures bashing together. I don't like the whole Green Goblin design in that film. I think they should have used prosthetics and utilised Willem Dafoe's face a lot more, and that's one thing that Spider-Man No Way Home does get right with Dafoe's Goblin. They absolutely let him act his heart out, and you can see his face, and it's just a shame that, you know, in the 2002 original, they just had him behind this plastic like kind of like face. He looked like a bloody Power Ranger, and it just didn't work for me. And he didn't really have a motivation for kind of like, you know, being against Spider-Man. You know, he wanted them to team up because he said, well, you know, they'll turn against you eventually, Spider-Man. You know, join with me. And because of Spider-Man Reviews, he then kind of like went after his, you know, friends and family. It just didn't make sense, that second half of the film. But the first half of the film was great. Spider-Man 2 is virtually flawless. It's one of those rare sequels that is better than the original. And then Spider-Man 3, kind of all went a bit wrong there, didn't it? With the introduction of Venom, who was shoehorned into the film against Sam Raimi's wishes. They should have really just kept it as New Goblin and Sandman, and saved Venom for a potential fourth film had they got round to doing it. But they couldn't then agree doing a fourth film, and then because they were all out of contract, so then they decided to reboot it. But this is Tobey Maguire's Spider-Man, and I really like the colours here. I was just watching a YouTube video from a channel called Stan Fine, and he did a review on Spider-Man 2, which I was watching this morning. And these colours are absolutely accurate to how they appear in the movie. They are spot on. The blue isn't too light, blue isn't too dark. The red is absolutely the right red colour. And they've really got that wash on the silver web lines perfect. It really was a good costume. And, you know, it keeps the aesthetics of the comic book character, but then it does the kind of realistic approach for the movie. And interesting fact, the Spider-Man costume for the Spider-Man trilogy was designed by a Mr. James Acheson, who is a very famous costume designer in Hollywood, Oscar-winning costume designer. But he started his career at the BBC, and he's probably most famous for designing Tom Baker's Doctor Who costume with the scarf. Yes, he was the guy who designed the look of the Fourth Doctor. So a little bit of an interesting fact there for you. So he's coming with the fists. Let's just check out the alternate hands that you get for this one. He stands up a lot better. Now, is this the right bag? No, I don't think that is. I think that's Andrew Garfield's hands. Ah, yeah. Okay, here we go. So, we've got the web-slinging hands, which are brilliant. As you can see there. Lovely paint application on it. Lovely attention to detail. And then you've got like the wall crawling hands. Now I've seen a couple of reviews that say that why has he got really stumpy fingers compared to the other two Spider-Man? Let's just get a comparison here of, just look at that. Just look how short his fingers are in comparison to Tom Holland's. I'd just presume that's movie accurate. Is it because like Tobey Maguire's got shorter, stubby hands? Who knows? But yeah, so you've got that option there, and again, the hands will pop off quite easily. Let's just put that one on so we can have him in that kind of a pose there, and perhaps a web slinging hand for that one. I don't know why I always put the right hand as the web slinging hand, but there we go. But loving this figure, I love the paintwork. In some places it looks like the silver isn't painted, but it's just the way it reflects in the light. Every line on here is painted. And at some points you think, oh no, they've missed a bit. But then you move it around in the light and you can see that they have painted it. So it's really, really good. I like the fact that obviously the logo goes up again. Now, Hasbro got the license for Spider-Man and Marvel Legends, as they were, from Toy Biz in 2007. So they did Spider-Man toys for Spider-Man 3. Now, I haven't got any of those, but I have got the Spider-Man 2 Spider-Man, which is here. And so here's a bit of a comparison. Now, this was produced by a company called Toy Biz, who owned Marvel at the time. They famously bought out Marvel from bankruptcy in the mid-1990s when Marvel was in real trouble. So they obviously used to release Marvel-themed toys as well. But yeah, just look at the difference in the action figures. There's a lot more kind of like movement articulation on here. But also then there's some areas where you've got like kind of like the shoulder joints where you've got, because of the necessity of the technology at the time, you've got obviously no paintwork. And then you've got obviously pins, which, you know, those figures had. We've only recently moved to pinless technology for action figures. But the thing that gets me is the fact that you've got articulation on these hands. Every single finger moves. So you don't need alternate hands at all, because you can just move the fingers and do the web slinging pose like that. So that's cool. I had dug this out of storage. I finally found it. I knew I had it somewhere, and it was in, actually, in a box in the shed. Yeah, the face is a little bit scuffed and damaged. But it's interesting to just to see how the technology has moved on. Obviously, you've got the waist here, which moves, you know, around like so. So it gives him ultra amount of poseability. But then compare that to obviously here, where it's more kind of like structured together. It's like, obviously, that's obviously what the technology did at the time, but it makes him look like a little bit deformed of the way that it clicks out. And obviously the top area doesn't quite gel with the bottom area, whereas here it's a lot smoother. So that's just a lovely comparison there of two toys that are effectively 19 years apart, bizarrely. So this came out in 2004. It was part of the Spider-Man 2 range. I picked it up at the time just because I thought it was like a cool looking figure. And obviously this is released now in 2023. So there you go. There's a comparison of two Tobey Maguire Spider-Man action figures. But yeah, really loving that. More accurate to the movie. Obviously better sculpted. It just shows you how the technology with action figures has moved on over the time. So there's Peter 2. On to Peter.
Wish we could see Peter.
Salamakiru.
Lola, you're right. I am magic.
Is that him?
Yeah. Okay. It has to be.
Peter! Peter!
Hey, Peter!
Peter!
Yeah. No, it's okay. I'm a nice guy.
Okay. Who the hell are you?
I'm Peter Parker.
That's not possible.
I am Spider-Man in my world. But then yesterday, I was just here.
So, on to Peter 3, the amazing Spider-Man, as portrayed by Andrew Garfield. And wow, look at that figure. That's amazing. No pun intended. that is cool. A lot darker than I expected him to be, and a lot darker to how he appears on the packaging. But probably in line with how the costume was for this particular film. He's a lot brighter in The Amazing Spider-Man 2. But I just love this costume. This, for me, was the definitive looking Spider-Man. Again, it gets those eyes right. You know, they're just wide enough for the costume. The look of it was literally taking the best of all the versions of Spider-Man that we've had over the years in the comics. you know, you've got obviously, you know, the Steve Ditko original, you've got the John Romita Sr., you've then got the, you know, other versions, you know, John Romita Jr. Then did a great run, several great runs on the Spider-Man comic and defined his own look as well. Mark Bagley did Ultimate Spider-Man, which obviously this takes a little bit of that is inspiration from. Todd McFarlane as well did some groundbreaking work on the Amazing Spider-Man comic book and was, you know, responsible for the co-creation of Venom. But yeah, look at that. Really is amazing. Again, I've said it again, no pun intended. Lovely attention to detail on the back. Again, you've got that whole continuation of the back spider logo. You know, that's going into the second bit. You've got butterfly joints moving around. So you've got the posability there, which all these figures have. All these figures have the butterfly joints for the arms. You've got the hip swivel. You've got obviously bend articulation at the knees, which allows them to really like kind of bend back there. One interesting thing that none of these three figures have is the toe articulation, which just I don't have another kind of like figure from the Amazing Spider-Man to compare this with. But we do have the Renew Your Vows Spider-Man. And this guy did have toe articulation, which does make it good for if you really want to get that bendable, like posing with the figure. So it is kind of, it's got a bit of blue tack on there because sometimes he has difficulty standing up. So well, where he is on the display, that's kind of like, you know, where he is. So I would say that's probably the nearest to this particular version of Spider-Man. You can see actually the size difference. This guy's quite substantial actually, really, when you think about it. But yeah, it would have been nice if these three figures did come with toe articulation, because then that would just give you a little bit of extra flexibility for your posing. So again, he does come with the alternate hands. So let's just see them there. Oh dear, oh, they're all going over. Never mind. Okay, so what have we got here? So now, he's the only one who has two different options coming out of the packaging. So we've got a kind of, that's not really a wall crawling hand, I would say. Is it? That he's got there. And then he's got a fist. So he does come with an alternate fist for that hand. You've then got a wall crawling kind of hand for this hand. And then you've got, obviously, the two web-slinging hands you've got here, which just a lovely detail, lovely paintwork. The web lines on this, on all these figures, are really, really good. There's no paint mess-ups at all, which is always the danger with, you know, effectively buying blind in a box. Certainly buying blind online. This is only available through the Hasbro Pulse website. It is an exclusive to them. And yeah, it is a little bit pricey. Oh, another detail I've seen. You actually have the web shooter mechanisms on the underside of his wrists. That is brilliant. That is a brilliant attention to detail. There. Loving this figure. Loving all these figures. These are going to look great posed. So I will obviously, let's just pop that fist off there. Let's stick the web slinging hand on there. And I think you can see on there, he's got the little button on his palm, which he obviously presses when he's shooting his webs. That again, that is some attention to detail on there. And let's stand all these guys up. So you've got, obviously, Tom Holland is the smallest actor of the group. Then you've got, obviously, Tobey Maguire. And then you've got Andrew Garfield here. So they all are accurate to how they appear in the movie and the respective actors' heights. But yeah, just look at those. Three Spider-Men, absolutely brilliant. You just can't say fairer than that. So you could obviously get them coming through the portal as they did in the movie. So that looks cool as a display piece. I remember seeing this opening night. I think it was opening night I saw it. The crowd just went absolutely wild at that scene where Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man turned up and whipped his mask off. I've never known anything like it. I've never experienced anything like it. I was experiencing like some kind of cheering at the beginning of, like, you know, that Star Wars film, when a new Star Wars film has come out. And perhaps like a polite round of applause at an end of a film if people have enjoyed a film. But this was just like being an American audience, like the whooping, the hollering, you know, it's just, you know, it's just bizarre. And it's interesting when you watch the film back, it's almost as if the filmmakers were expecting the crowd to go wild because they've kind of like put those pauses in before the characters kind of like start saying anything important because they know that the audience is going to like whoop and cheer and holler. And then obviously you've got then Tobey Maguire arrive, but he wasn't in his costume. That would have been a unique figure to include in this set. You know, youth pastor Peter Parker. And again, he got a cheer, but not as big a cheer, which I was surprised at because obviously, you know, Tobey Maguire is the OG movie Spider-Man. But it just shows you the appreciation for Andrew Garfield. A lot of people do say, and I will go on record, he is my favourite Spider-Man. The way he was written, the way he acted. He was the perfect Peter Parker. He was the perfect Spider-Man. He got the quips and the jokes and the, you know, the one-liners right. It was like Spider-Man lifted up off the comic book page and put onto film. And again, you added that then with the costume that they then introduced in the second film. Yeah, the films are okay. The first film is hindered by retelling the reboot, the origin again. You didn't need to do that. You could have easily just had a soft reboot and continued it from the Raimi trilogy and just had a line dropped in about Mary Jane now moved to Europe to pursue a modelling career. And you'd already introduced Gwen Stacy in Spider-Man 3. So you could have then just continued that into The Amazing Spider-Man. And, you know, you could have just had a continuation. Almost like the James Bond films, where you just assume it's the same James Bond all the way through, except for when they did the proper reboot with Daniel Craig. But had they done that, then that would have not probably given us the option of obviously having, you know, two Spider-Men appear in this movie, because I presume then Andrew Garfield would have then worn a variation of this costume and it would have been in the same continuity and all that kind of thing. But yeah, Andrew Garfield got a bit of a rough deal, I think. You know, the films that he appeared in weren't the best Spider-Man films, but they had some great sequences in there. And I really wanted him to join the MCU, but they decided to then completely reboot the character again. Tom Holland is great in the role. I'm looking forward to see what they do now. The place where they've left him at the end of this Spider-Man movie, he's back to being the Spider-Man now from the comics. He's got no tech, which I didn't really like. I didn't like the whole Iron Kid suit that he kind of had. So he's now independent. He's living on his own. He's back to being the Peter Parker from the comics, and hopefully he's got a very much more comic accurate costume, which we briefly saw at the end of the movie. So really looking forward to whenever the next lot of Spider-Man films comes out to see what they do with it. And, you know, if these guys then turn up again in a future Marvel film, great. I'd love Andrew Garfield's character version of Spider-Man to pop up in the Venom movies and make that part of the Amazing Spider-Man universe. That would be really, really good, I think. because obviously Sony have their separate Spider universe because they hold the rights. I'm rambling. I just love these action figures. I'm now going to put them in a pose and see if I can get them similar to how they're appearing on the box art.
All we gotta do is focus, trust your tingle, and coordinate our attacks, okay?
Yes. Okay. Let's pick one target.
Right.
And we take them off the board one at a time.
Now you got it. Okay, Peter 1, Peter 2.
Peter 2.
Peter 3.
Peter 3.
All right, let's do this. Let's ready?
Wait.
I love you guys.
Thank you.
Well, that was certainly a bit more difficult than what I expected. Not quite getting them in the poses as they are on the artwork of the box. But, you know, I will have a further play around with it. But they are very, very poseable. So you can have them in a variety of poses. And I'm pretty sure, you know, I'll get them in kind of like the poses that I want them to be in for when I do make them as part of my display. What more can I say about these figures? They are one of the downsides, probably the main downside of this. You know, these are great figures. These two are brand new sculpts. This one is obviously effectively a re-release, repainted. They're expensive. They're exclusive, like I said, to Hasbro Pulse website. You can only get it there. It is £99 for the three figures, which effectively works out at £33 a figure. Well, now, when you think about it, the average Marvel Legends figure at the moment is retailing for £24.99. So effectively, you're paying £8 more for these figures. Yes, it is expensive, and it's more expensive than what it is in the US, because in the US they're $89.99, and that's dollars, and then you work out the exchange rate, that's probably just over 70 quid. So UK customers are getting a little bit screwed over here, very much screwed over, which is a shame, which is why I'm not buying any more Indiana Jones figures until I get over to the US, because I, with the rate of exchange, I can probably pick them up for a lot cheaper. But they are still great figures. Do I regret getting this set? No. Do I regret paying the price? Kind of, but this is probably the only opportunity you're going to get these free figures at this time. And that is the only downside. You know, Hasbro's increasing price rises. And again, I know I'm being hypocritical here. You know, I did say, oh, I won't pay Hasbro prices, you know, and all that kind of thing. And yeah, effectively, I'm either paying kind of like, you know, waiting for them to come down in price, cheap, like the Doctor Strange figure I reviewed yesterday. I've got two other Marvel Legends figures to review in a couple of weeks. I'll do those, which is a Wolverine and a Hobgoblin. And I got those both half price, you know. So I'm not paying full price for a lot of Hasbro products. The only other figure I bought recently full price was the Star Wars Black Series Mandalorian Luke Skywalker. So occasionally, yes, I will have to pay full price for certain products if I want them, because I don't see this being reduced anytime soon by Hasbro, because it is exclusive to their website. But you know, them's the breaks. Do you only purchase it if you feel it's worth it? It would have been nice if it came with a few more accessories, perhaps alternate heads, but as we say, there potentially might be an issue there with likeness rights and stuff. We will have to wait and see if these figures get re-released then with, you know, alternate heads. If they do, then it means that, you know, perhaps we should have held out, because if they then get re-released and then they're all £25 a pop, it means that you've paid more, you know. So anyway, them's the breaks. That's the perils of being an action figure collector, isn't it? You know, sometimes you have to take the rough with the smooth. But anyway, I will say they are a great set of figures. Absolutely brilliant. I especially love the Tobey Maguire Spider-Man and the Andrew Garfield Spider-Man. And I really actually like the look of the Tom Holland one as well. I think the Tom Holland one will be replacing this guy in my display, which I'll probably shove to the back of it. what more can I say? Pay it if you feel it's worth it. If you don't, perhaps hold out in the hope that Hasbro will reduce it. But if they do reduce it, they'll probably do it as part of their promotion of you being a member of Hasbro Pulse, which means that you have to subscribe to them. So you'd have to pay them a subscription to then qualify for the discount. And those are sometimes the catches that a multi-billion dollar corporation will throw in your way to stop you trying to, like, you know, get stuff for cheap. But I cannot fault these three figures, even though the price is just a little bit too high. But it is absolutely fantastic and amazing. And I'm glad I've got these figures in my collection. So there you have it. The Marvel Legends Spider-Man No Way Home three figure set. And before we go, I forgot to include the web lines that you get with them. So you can have them posed with it. It's got a nice little thing that makes you can have it hanging round the actual wrist there, so it does look as if they're, like, you know, shooting their webs. It's a nice little feature, you know, and then potentially, because it's got a hook on there, you could potentially, like, have them hanging, you know, or swinging if you wanted to do that as a display. But that's obviously how you would probably have them with the web lines. But besides that, they're kind of like, yeah, a nice little extra, but not really much use in the grand scheme of things. It just looks like they're shooting. I'll stop that right there. Anyway, just pan back just to show you that obviously there's all the Spider-Man figures that I've got. Toy Biz Spidey from 2004 up the top. And then we've got the other No Way Home Spider-Man. We've got Renew Your Vows Spider-Man. And then we've got Japanese Spider-Man at the back there. So a nice little Spidey display of all the Spidey figures I currently have. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, then please leave us a like. It really does help out the channel. And also, if you've not yet subscribed to the channel, please hit that subscribe button and that notification bell to be notified whenever we upload any brand new videos. We are going to be taking a break for a couple of weeks with special actual figure reviews because we're going on holiday. We're going on to Orlando, to Walt Disney World and Universal very, very soon. So there's not going to be any, like, actual figure reviews coming up, but I will try and do perhaps a couple of quick merchandise video showing you what the theme parks have on offer with regards to Star Wars, Marvel and Indiana Jones merch. I know in Disney Hollywood Studios they've got quite a big Indiana Jones merchandise to tie in with obviously the release of the new film, The Dial of Destiny. But we will be back very, very soon. So stay patient and in the meantime, take care, stay safe, and we will see you very, very soon on Bearded Geek Toy Reviews. See you now. Right, how do I get out of this dimension now?
You make both of you listen to Peter One. Look, we're clearly not very good at this.
I know, we suck. I don't know how to work as a team.
Me neither.
Well, I do. I have been in a team, okay? I don't want to brag, but I will. I was in the Avengers.
The Avengers?
Yeah.
That's great.
Thank you.
What is that?
Wait, you don't have the Avengers?
Is that a band? Are you in a band?